On today's show, Star Wars news. According to Laura Dern, Admiral Holdo is force sensitive? What? Also want to talk about the X-Men movies being delayed. This is the New Mutants movie and the Dark Phoenix film. Does this have something to do with the Disney Fox purchase? I don't know. We're going to get into that. It's also new comic book day, so I want to talk about my pull list and what books you should definitely be reading. This is the Nerdy News Rundown. What is up, everybody? Welcome to the show. We've got a ton of awesome topics to get into and some cool fan questions. Well, I guess just one cool fan question submitted by somebody yesterday about Luke Skywalker. That's going to be really cool. I, of course, want to shout out Uncanny for sponsoring this video, being a big part of what I am doing here on this channel. Uncanny is awesome. Go check them out. Also, guys, if you wouldn't mind, drop a like on this video. We haven't been getting a lot of likes on these videos, and I know that a ton of you love the videos, so do me a big favor and drop a like. Now, let's get right into the first topic of today. Laura Dern was doing an interview and hinted that her character is force sensitive. I want to read some of her quotes right here. So this comes from an interview with EW, and she's being asked about the backstory for her character. And she says here, "In their minds and in the understanding of the origin story, we know that she was a true rebel in the resistance. And in our culture, we might have called her a hippie." This is pretty cool, and I'll get to that in a second and why it's so awesome, but I'll go on. "But she was longing for peace and a revolutionary in that way, and wanted to be trained by and led by Leia, who taught her everything she knew. She wanted to come up in the ranks to support Leia's mission, but also had this otherworldly side that does involve the Force." So obviously she's not specifically trained in the Force, but she did mention the Force there. And here's something else that Laura said. She says there's something about her that longs to protect it and hold it with great care. There's a sort of light on and a wisdom that she speaks about in the film and speaks to Oscar Isaac's character briefly about it. Yeah, her primary goal was to protect the light, to protect the Force, and to keep the revolutionaries alive. I think the film speaks so beautifully to that with this last image of the next generation of the resistance, you know? She's, of course, referring to Broom Boy when she says that. So a lot of people have been talking about this, talking about what Laura Dern said and saying, hey, does this mean that Laura Dern's character was force sensitive? And I would say that Laura Dern's character was not incredibly force sensitive, but was aware of the Force and probably had some kind of connection to this. Now, quickly, I have to stop and say something that was told by Pablo Hidalgo to all the Star Wars fans. Not a lot of us like to admit this, but essentially everybody in the galaxy is force sensitive in some way. Pablo Hidalgo has famously said that when Han Solo is doing something in a spaceship that defies possibilities, he is tapping into the Force. When Oscar Isaac's Poe Dameron is doing some of the crazy things that he is doing, he is tapping into the Force. Anytime you are in a flow state or in the zone and doing the thing that you are really good at and you are defying laws of logic, you are technically tapping into the Force. However, this does not mean that she was trained in how to use the Force by Leia, although that is a possibility, as we know from the novelization of The Last Jedi, that Leia received such training from her brother Luke. I think the bottom line with this story is Holdo being force sensitive doesn't matter. Holdo is a stupid character, and a lot of people think this. In fact, if you watch the honest trailer that Screen Junkies just put out for The Last Jedi yesterday, both sides, which are meant to represent the two sides of the divide on The Last Jedi, both sides agree that the Holdo character was kind of crappy and super contrived for the purpose of pushing the plot forward. Having said this, the one thing that did actually make me feel good when reading this was that she at least knew something about this character. That hippie thing that she says does imply that the Lucasfilm Story Group did tell Laura Dern about the history of this character, which was laid out for us in the Leia novel. It does sort of bring up some confusing questions, like why wasn't she more like the character that she knew she was supposed to represent? And in the behind-the-scenes features on The Last Jedi, they talk about how Laura Dern's character was changed a lot in post. A lot of the reshoots, a lot of the different things that happened with this character were made because of some of the scenes they saw in post. Ryan took a completely different direction with this character, making her more abrasive and more mysterious. Getting back to the Force sensitivity thing, I suppose it is possible that she was trained with the Force. It's even possible that she has a little bit more of an inkling or a connection to the Force than most average people, but I don't think she'd have anywhere near the connective way that a Skywalker had or that a Jedi had or anything like that. Once again, I don't think it necessarily matters that much because either way, whether she's Force sensitive or not, a lot of people did not like the Holdo character, and I think the changes they made in post were actually bad changes. But that's the report out there. Apparently, Grand Admiral Holdo was Force sensitive, or at least saw it as a part of her mission to protect the Force, which I can buy a little bit more. I mean, this whole Godspeed Rebels things that she and the other admirals say, that has something to do with the religion of her own personal planet. And I love this idea that the Force is a way for all religions and all different people around the galaxy to decide that, yeah, that's what we're talking about. When we talk about God, we're talking about the Force. The Force is that thing that connects and binds us all. So that's the story. I definitely want to know what everybody has to say about that. Chime in the comments section below. Do you think Holdo was Force sensitive? Maybe more Force sensitive than other people? Did she get any training from Leia? Does it matter at all? And should we just stop talking about The Last Jedi? All right, let's get into our next topic. This has to do with the two new X-Men films and why they are being delayed by Fox. This is, of course, the New Mutants movie and the Dark Phoenix movie. Now, New Mutants was already pushed back a little bit, but apparently now it is being pushed back even further all the way into next year, and Dark Phoenix is being pushed from a late this year release to February of next year. So there's a lot of different rumors circulating around. People are confused and want answers. Steve Frosty Weintraub did sit down with John Rocha on the Collider channel and speak to what he thought was going on, and it's pretty telling. In that interview or that little piece, they talk about how the studios are not happy with where these movies are at. They have shown them to test audiences, done test screenings, and they are going to make tweaks now based upon the feedback that they receive. This is always something that people do in Hollywood, but it does seem to be more prevalent nowadays. People really want to make these great films, and we hear a lot of talk about how the blockbusters are dying in Hollywood, and despite Disney absolutely crushing it in the box office, the total number for these blockbuster films is actually way down. Ticket totals are way down, and a lot of people get nervous when they're pumping a bunch of money into these films. However, the proven formula lately has been franchising and has been these big superhero comic book properties. And so a lot of people are saying that these properties now surpass the value of even the creative teams behind them. Now, specifically with the New Mutants movie, the director Josh Boone already went through some sort of reshoots. He submitted what he thought was a great movie, and the studio wanted the film to be more scary. They're going after the horror genre with this film, and the reason it was initially delayed was because they were going to add one or more characters to really amp up the scariness. Now we're hearing they are going to remake about half of that film and push it back till way further down the line in 2019. Now, Josh Boone might not even be a part of these reshoots, and it just shows once again the Hollywood formula these days is really make this movie that basically respects the IP, and that is more important than the creative vision of any one person. I don't know how I personally feel about that, but I do want to see this New Mutants movie. I'm at a loss. I really don't know, man. I mean, I think Josh Boone probably did a great job. It's pretty weird that they're going to remake that movie. With Dark Phoenix specifically, I think especially because what happened with the X-Men Apocalypse movie, they are being very careful about how to set this up for future franchising. And once again, if they have to spend an extra $50 million on this movie to make sure that it not only makes enough money itself, but sets up future films, I mean, that is clearly a good idea. So that's the stories out there, guys. New Mutants and Dark Phoenix, both delayed until next year. What a weird story. Do you happen to think that maybe something to do with the Disney Fox purchase is behind this? Nobody is reporting that that is a part of what is happening, but I think when you take that into account, it makes even more sense that they're going to delay. Maybe Fox secretly thinks they could just hand all this over to Marvel and allow them to just fix it. I don't really know. That is what's being reported. That is the story. I want to know what all of you guys think about that in the comment section below. All right, guys, it's new comic book day. Now we got to talk about what comics you should be reading. I want to go through a couple of them very quickly and then highlight the one that I enjoyed the most from today. So you've got a couple of Marvel Bendis books. Bendis is, of course, on his way out from Marvel. He's going to be taking over at DC for Action Comics and Superman. You have The Invincible Iron Man. This is a pretty good book. I've enjoyed it quite a bit. And his last issue of Jessica Jones, you're definitely going to want to check those out if you've been a big fan of what Bendis did at Marvel for over 20 years. Avengers No Surrender, which has been Marvel's very ambitious story that's coming out weekly, is now in its 12th part. Pretty cool. If you've been enjoying that story, it continues that pace. It's pretty awesome. You also have Doomsday Clock number 4. This book is the telling of how and why the characters from the Watchmen universe are now joined into the regular DC universe. It was a pretty good read. I did enjoy it, but it was just edged out by my other favorite DC book this week. That would be Dark Knight's Metal. This is the conclusion to the Dark Knight's Metal storyline, and it also sets up some very interesting stuff for the future of DC Comics. Now, personally, I've enjoyed Metal. I did think it got a little too comic booky in the middle and was sort of hard to follow. Overall, it was pretty badass. A lot of cool stuff happening there, and this issue in particular gives us some of the coolest moments of the entire series. It wraps it up in a nice little bow, but it also sets up a very exciting future for the Justice League. This is something that DC has been soliciting, where Darkseid himself will be joining the Justice League, and they are going to be going around to face amazing new cosmic threats. Essentially, you could think of the entire DC universe as this little bubble and all this really bad stuff outside of it. Well, that bubble is broken now, and all of this crazy bad stuff is out there, and the Justice League is going to power up, take things to a whole new level. Scott Snyder's taking over that book, and he's going to be going around with Darkseid as a member of the Justice League. It's pretty exciting stuff, and it gets set up at the end of Dark Knight's Metal number 6. So those are some of the comics that I really enjoyed. Make sure you go out to your local comic book store. If you're in the Philadelphia area, come to one of the Uncanny locations. They'll be able to guide you, get you the books that you need, set up a pull list. That's really, really cool stuff. All right, let's finish this show off with a fan question. This was submitted by somebody yesterday on the video where I was talking about George Lucas's original ending for episode 9. The person made a point to ask me if I thought certain things were going to be happening in episode 9, especially now that Mark Hamill has been so vocal about wanting to come back, and if they did that, if that would help the fans that were hurt by The Last Jedi. And I want to say thank you for the question. I mean, we've been talking a lot about Mark Hamill's Luke Skywalker episode 9. Been talking a lot about that this week. I think it's a pretty fair question. Obviously, The Last Jedi was this monumental division within the Star Wars fan base. A lot of people did not like the fact that Luke Skywalker was taken out of the story. I tend to believe that he will be brought back in 9. I think that will be a nice olive branch to the fans. I hope he's used in a very interesting and cool way. But even if he is only in the film slightly with sort of a small role, I would still really enjoy it. I think it would be a mistake to not have him in there. And I do think that no matter what, JJ will give us an episode 9, which will wrap things up in a very cool way, and people will look at this trilogy a little bit better than they are looking at it right now. I'm not saying that he's going to retcon a bunch of stuff, but I do think that he's hyper aware of where the fan base is at. And for certain fans that might have problems with certain things in The Last Jedi, I believe episode 9 will be delivered in a way to sort of alleviate some of that pain. But anyways, I want to thank you so much for the question. I want to thank everybody who's been supporting the show. We've been going through some changes, some growing pains, a lot of interesting things happening, but you guys have been very supportive and awesome. I really appreciate it. As I always say, I hope you are having an awesome and a nerdy day, and I will see you tomorrow. Oh wow, I'm in a smaller screen now. I don't know what's going on, but it probably has something to do with these things that you should click. You should probably click these things. Click them.